Hello and welcome back to Ture TV. Pray you are well and I pray you are doing great. If this is your first time, don't forget to subscribe, like and share the videos. The healthcare system in Africa is far way back. It's way beyond expectation. Most of our leaders don't take the healthcare system seriously. When you take this great nation, Nigeria, for example, during this pandemic, the leaders are more concerned about renovating the National Assembly and reducing the budget for education and healthcare. Is it because whenever they get sick, they do run to the Western world in order to fix themselves or to India or China? We are supposed to fix that. We are supposed to meet our leaders to fix that problem. It's not everybody who can be able to afford going to the Western world in order to fix their problem, in order to get a good medication that they require. And in doing so, they tend to give millions or spend millions of dollars out of Africa and to the Western world again. It has to be reversed. The people in the healthcare system or in the healthcare should come down to Africa, those people with interest, after registering with Her Excellency Dr. Arikana's our ADDI.org. We should come together, open hospitals in the stable regions of Africa first. Whoever is sick and needs a medical attention outside, instead of taking that person outside Africa, that person should be treated in Africa. Instead of taking the money out of Africa to the Western world, let the money remain in Africa. Similarly, when it comes to the education, our people have been going to the Western world in order to educate. Our people have been going to the Western world in order to get good quality education. And in so doing, they tend to take money out of Africa once again to the Western world, because you have to pay for the education. Any semester, you do pay for it. You have to pay for the hotel that you lodge, the visas, and so on and so forth. So people in the education sector who are interested in opening universities in Africa, good quality universities which will cater for the education that our people do require, they require, instead of going over to the Western world in order to educate yourself, you should open those universities strategically in other places, in different countries, in different countries, to cater for the education of our people. People who want to study mechanical engineering should maybe go to Egypt to study that. Have dispersed the universities throughout Africa. Anyone that you want, anyone that you are interested in, you should have a place that you go to in order to get the education here in Africa without spending the money outside. These are ideas that when we do embark on, we will have a whole lot of issues solved. Most of our leaders do take the money out of Africa and then invest in the Western world. And when they die, before the money moves back to Africa, it takes years. For example, the former head of state of Nigeria, General Sani Abacha, who died and left billions of dollars in the Western world. When they take 10 to 20 years, they will shift something down to Africa. When he wanted to take the money over there, it did not take him 10 to 20 years to shift the money to the Western world. But when it comes to repatriating the money back to Africa, see what they have been doing? But when it comes to repatriating the money down back to Africa, they should take 10 to 20 years before they do that. And before they do that, they don't send the money 100%. They do send, trade with it, they get their interest, they make their gains before they send part of the money down to Africa. And when they do, the government of the day do misuse the funds as well. Where are we going with all these mindsets? Where are we going? Where are we going? The bulk of our people are sitting at home, jobless, and you want crime to decline in Africa, crime will not decline, because they wouldn't like crime to decline. If crime declines, their weapons will not sell as well. So these are issues which needs to be addressed. But as usual, the AU has been there under the French, under the tutelage of France, Moussa Faki, who cannot do anything about it because he's afraid of the finger that feeds him. And this is how we are going to continue if care is not taken. Oh Africa. According to Professor Pierre Lumumba, and people with ideas don't have power, and people with power don't have ideas. They are just there. Until next time, we are together.